Hello everyone, today we are going to be taking a look at the RPC-3, the smallest Turing-complete redstone computer in Minecraft. If you're new to the channel, then allow me to introduce myself. I am CT5K, and I'm known for the Redstone Personal Computer, also called the RPC. The RPC is the third iteration of my technology, and there are several benefits to using this PC rather than the RPC 1 or 2. For one, this is the first computer that is Turing-complete. For those of you who don't know what that means, Turing-completeness is a way of defining a computer's abilities. For two, this is the most code-dense RPC and possibly the most code-dense hex computer on YouTube. What makes the code so dense is the redesigned output port. With every RPC, I've redesigned the output port to better help the programmer, and this is no exception. The computer itself uses 6 functions, but Redstone Hexadecimal provides up to 15 functions. So instead of having the extra 9 functions go to waste, I've just built this line to subtract 6 and have sort of a function overflow. So while we lose 6 functions for external hardware, we reduce the execution of that hardware by about 5 lines of code, which for a system that has very limited memory, every line counts. This is also the smallest redstone computer, with dimensions being 12 by 8 by 3. This makes its volume 288 cubic blocks, a good 300 blocks smaller than the RPC-2. Functions are pretty standard for an RPC. We have a set register 2, a wipe register 3. Note, there is no register 4 in this computer, since it wasn't the best option for a function output and was unnecessary. So then we have the addition of register 1 and register 2, and then we have this function for setting register 1. Now, like with every RPC, we can wipe register 1 and register 2, but they are both wiped at the same time. Lastly, we have not register 1 and the conditional if register 1 is equal to 0. Now you might have noticed these yellow blocks and wonder what they are for. So this is the function overflow that I was discussing earlier. So as you can see, if we input a 7 here, this comparator gets outputted with a 1. So that works from 7 up to the value of 15. Just take whatever number this is and subtract 6 from it, and that's your function output. Let's get down to building this. This build is Java and Bedrock compatible. It's pretty difficult to build simply because there's a lot of parts that we have to take into account and squeeze into this tiny space. First off, let's begin by building our 2 input registers. Once we have that done, we're going to build our ALU. Now that the ALU is done, it's time to build the output register. Unlike the RPC-2, the RPC-3 only has 1 register for storing the output. Once that is done, we will build our lines connecting the core together. While we're at it, let's go ahead and build our data in line. Now that we have the core built, it's time to finish up the RPC-3. We will build our decoder. Now note for Bedrock players, you will need to set these top repeaters to 2 ticks. Otherwise, you will be one ticking the torches. Now we will connect the control lines from the decoder to their respective function. First, let's start off with an easy one and connect the NOT for register 1. Now, let's build the circuit to wipe register 1 and register 2. Once that's done, let's build this line which allows us to set register 1. Next comes the addition control, followed by wipe register 3. Our last line is for setting register 2. Now that we have the control lines built, let's build the function overflow line. Like I stated earlier, this is just a way of subtracting 6 from our function input, since the RPC-3 itself uses 6 functions. One more thing that we need to build is the conditional, so let's go ahead and get that built. And there we have it, the RPC-3. Now I will be leaving world downloads in the description, as well as a world edit schematic for you Java users. If the links don't work for some reason, then just go over to ct5k.com, go to Redstone, and click on Project Gamma. While you're over there, make sure to check out my store, where you can get all kinds of cool Redstone-themed merchandise. If you need further help with this computer, then check out my Discord server. The link to that will also be in the description below. Anyways, that's it for today. I'm CT5K, and I'll see you in the next one.